is a work done by a climatologist. He has a lidar, and he took vegetation, and these are the vegetation at different levels. 2 meters, 10 meters, 20 meters, 40 meters. So he wanted to study in this case with in the paper is here. He wants to study with the Kriging the correlation between the canopy and the various levels. So as you see, the interpolation is not limited to the temperature or rainfall or whatever, but it's limited to our creativity to use the tool. And the variography, because we have to do with variograms. And so I am telling you a little bit what variograms are about. And this is the form of a variogram. The dots should represent the experimental variogram we got yesterday, but the dots are really mild this year. Experimental variogram that you will obtain are more wide than that. That's the historian interpretation of life, which is better than real life. And the red line is the model that is interpolated, and you start to notice one strange thing. If you look at the definition, you think that the variogram has to go to zero at zero. And here it's not going to zero. Why? I tell you later on. Anyway, it's not going to zero this real case. So our model of variogram doesn't go to zero too. And the intercept with the y-axis is called nugget, meaning there is a nugget, something there. Actually, this means that the variogram, we know the theoretically has to go to zero, but this means that the sampling, you're sampling a space too large for detecting the curve going to zero. So for you, it's like you find a nugget there. There is you find nothing before you find the fact the nugget, and there is some in your sample, there is something happening inside the small space that you don't see. Your process is correlated at the distance which is not revealed by the measurements you get. I see your faces and you don't understand the question. Okay. If you have this curve is the time going to zero in reality, but you don't have, you have to take samples very, very close to the test. And we don't have both samples. So we have the nugget and the nugget. We see also that the variogram usually, but we have also a sample of variogram that don't go to an asymptotic value. And usually go to an asymptote. And this asymptote is called seal or total seal. There is a certain point here where the seal is obtained, and this is called the range. Essentially, what we can think is that the two measures are correlated if they are close enough. And close enough is quantified by the range. Two measures that are aside from more than the range are not correlated. Also. So this is the range. And in the Moller case, when two measures are correlated, their measure is correlated, and even that is again. Okay? Your measures are correlated. Your measure is Leo measures are not correlated. variograms would be extreme like this one. You have a point where at 0 is 0, where you have your random process, and you have no special structure at all. Or if that's it, it's really what we call random, but actually it's called white noise. Special white noise. This is how much to be when you're not receiving anything. Just a situation of the universe. This is the total field. If the total variability according to the variogram is given in our sense. This is a theoretical thin variogram. This is a possibility for an empirical variogram, the dotted, the black line, the black dot. And you see that the other one is an interpolation of a variogram. There is a nugget effect, you see, that is detected here too. I don't remember which. It's a Gaussian type of a model, then you see the model. So more or less you have to reproduce figures like that. Real figures is a big word for that. Because here there are a lot of special, a lot of points. Because you see, we have a distance and speed, we have a lot of close by angles. So this actually was done a very defined number of measurements that we usually don't have. So going back, this actually what is our experimental variogram in reality. We have a cloud of points usually oscillating wildly, oscillating if we connect each other. This is what we do is we separate classes of points which we need to divide into three intervals. And then we average the points in each interval and we obtain a better figure and then we go to the second. That's more or less the operation that you do also. You are asked to do. And in part the machine does for you. The conceptual operation is this one. Take the point, subdivide the point by in part of the selected distance, make a statistic in the scheme, interpolating the value. So we have different models of variograms that people evolved during the years. And this is called the spherical model. The formula is more or less, if you want, you don't need to learn like in memory unless you use every day, every week. Because there are French shapes. The right thing that you have to mind is nugget, field, range, and the distance of it. That's the variable. This is a spherical model. If you have a field which is distributed with a special variogram, it's more or less like you see visually. And this model is totally linear in the origin. This is a cubic model which is harmonic in the origin. You see the random field results from this choice. Is a little bit different to have an idea of what happens. And you know, we're talking about getting the data and building the variograms and then learning something about our data. But in this case we also envision a process in which we give the guy a variogram, we do a random sampling, and we generate a field like this one. We generate ourselves a field. In this case, those fields that you see are pure generated computational according to a certain distribution. So when you generate a distribution in space, you have two choices. One choice is to distribute according to probability distribution, or the other. At the same time, you can respect a spatial correlation. The spatial correlation structure on the signal. This is the exponential model. This is a very famous model. Very famous, it's very simple. It is one parameter. These are the three parameters of the variogram. And we have to adapt. We have the data, we have the model, we choose the model for the variogram, and we have to adapt